I'm here in San Pedro to show you how to use one of our volunteer white sea bass fin clip kits. These fin clip kits will be used to collect data for our white sea bass hatchery program. Hi, I'm Valerie Taylor, and I'm a senior environmental scientist with the California Department of Fish and Wildlife. I'm also the coordinator for our Ocean Resources Enhancement and Hatchery Program, also known as ORHAP.
So your fin clip will include a mailing envelope, instructions, a data sheet to collect any data that you have, wet wipes to clean your scissors with, filter paper and coin envelopes that are used for the white sea bass fin clip, as well as a set of scissors. Just grab a piece of the filter paper. What I like to do is put it underneath the white sea bass fin, and then all you do is have to cut a little piece off the fin, and then set it aside in a safe area and let it dry out a little bit before you put it in the envelope, and then clean your scissors.
So on the data sheet, write your angler name, address, phone number, and email so we can contact you if we have any questions regarding your data sheet. Then match the corresponding envelope number on the data sheet and put the date. If you were able to get a total length, put a total length. And if you have a block code or a Latin long, you can write that in as well. And any other notes that you have, either head turned into the freezer, you released it, or anything else that you might feel is important for the department to know. Once the fin has dried out, fold it and then put it in the corresponding coin envelope. Don't seal it, just keep it loose. In the envelope provided, put the data sheet along with any coin envelopes you have. And then you can mail that to the address listed on the envelope.
Thank you very much. This data actually will contribute to our department's genetic study, looking at the hatchery contribution of white sea bass to the wild population.
If you'd like a white sea bass fin clip kit, send an email to the address listed in the description. If you'd like to learn more, visit wildlife.ca.gov.